gentlemen, welcome. We are gathered here today to witness my debut as a wedding officiant. If there are two people here more nervous, it's me. No, but seriously, we are gathered here today to celebrate the marriage of Elizabeth and Grigor. I had the opportunity to personally watch Elizabeth and Grigor's love grow over a year at Cornell, and Facebook has allowed me to continue stalking them over the past 3 years. We once again find ourselves together back in New York, and this weekend has helped remind me why we became such good friends 4 years ago. Thank you for making me a part of your special day. While I myself am not married, I have been fortunate enough to have parents who have provided a wonderful model for what love and marriage should look like. I believe that marriage is one of the deepest, strongest, and most binding connections that one can have with another. It's hard, easy, frustrating, invigorating, but ultimately one of the most powerful connections we can experience. Grigor and Elizabeth, your relationship has evolved throughout the years from friends to boyfriend and girlfriend to fiancé. This evolution has taken years to develop to this level of companionship, and that's not something that will change today. Today is September 4th, and for the rest of your lives, you will know this day only as your anniversary. Well, next year it's also going to be Labor Day. I digress. You are officially married today, almost. You have wonderful times ahead, difficult times ahead, but the love and commitment you share with one another will see you through it all. But this moment, the wedding, is regarded as one so critical, we acknowledge this commitment by sharing this day with others. Friends and family travel hundreds, thousands of miles for this moment, and maybe the free booze, but really what brings us here today is love. In my humble opinion, there are two types of love. One is incredibly natural and involuntary, while the other is cultivated and built through admiration and respect. It's almost effortless to love things with natural value, like a 1980 Chevy El Camino, the harmony of voices from teen pop sensation One Direction, the incredible athleticism of LeBron James, or the chiseled abs of Channing Tatum. These things are easy to love because there's something about them that is inherently valuable to us. But then there's this other type of love. And this type of love doesn't seek physical value in the thing that it loves. Instead, it creates value in the thing that it loves. See, some things are loved because they are valuable, and some things are valuable because they are loved. It's this indescribable, unconditional, complete, and total love that is dependent on the character and the commitment of the lover, and not the performance of the one who is loved. This just happens to be the same kind of love God has for us. There is nothing inherently valuable about any single one of us to make us worthy of God's love, yet He loves us anyway. In fact, in each of us, there are qualities that make us inherently unworthy of God's love, yet He loves us anyway. Now, I'm certainly not a priest, but I know that this type of love is what's going to make a marriage last. Marriage isn't going to be easy. Inevitably, there's going to be conflict, and conflict can either build you up or tear you down. If your love is based purely upon judging the performance of one another, then conflict will tear you apart. There are going to be times when you will disappoint each other. Eventually, she's going to stop shaving her legs. And eventually, he's going to stop putting the toilet seat back there. Or worse, never lifting it. But if you work to love each other the way that God loves each of us, if you decide today that your love will be based on the character and the commitment of the lover and not the performance of the loved, truly unconditional love, your marriage will be happy and truly ever after. With our love and prayers, we support Grigor and Liz as they now give themselves to each other. Kristen will now do a reading from the Old Testament.
From Ruth chapter 1, verses 16 to 17. But Ruth said, "Do not urge me to leave you or turn my back from you. Where you go, I will go, and wherever you stay, I will stay. Your people shall be my people, and your God my God. Where you die, I will die, and there be buried. May the Lord do this unto me, and move if even death separates me from you."
Today, Grigor and Elizabeth are vowing to be as inseparable as Naomi and Ruth. Marriage is about commitment and faithfulness. It is important to think of Ruth as an example for the promises you make to each other today and to start your journey together. Those of us in attendance today are present to witness a statement of lasting love and commitment between Grigor and Elizabeth. I ask you now, in the presence of God and these witnesses, to declare your intentions to enter into marriage with one another. Grigor, do you take Elizabeth to be your lawful wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do you part?
I do.
Elizabeth, do you take Grigor for your lawful husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do you part?
I do.
And now they will exchange their own personal vows.
Grigor, I love that you are so supportive and loving, and I vow to be as supportive and loving for you as well. I promise to appreciate you every day and never take you for granted, and I promise to support you in all of your endeavors. I also promise to keep the QWERTY count below 10, unless we have a QWERTY count. Just as I give you my hand to hold today, I give you my heart. I choose you today, and I choose you again tomorrow, and I will choose you every day for the rest of our lives. Cousin Sirman.
Liz, you're my best friend. You know how to make me laugh and smile, and you know me better than anyone else. You turn me into a QWERTY person and make me happier than I even thought was possible. Every day I get to come home to you in Winston, I feel like the luckiest person on the planet. I vow to take care of you, to take you on nice dinners, go on walks with you, go on adventures with you, respect you, and love you for the rest of my life.
To commemorate this union, you may now exchange rings. The circle formed by each ring symbolizes your eternal love and commitment to one another. Let these rings always remind you of that love and of the promises you have made here on this day. Will each of you please repeat after me as you place this ring on your loved one's hand? I, Grigor, give you, Elizabeth, this ring as a symbol of my love and commitment.
This ring is a symbol of my love and commitment.
With this ring, I be wed.
With this ring, I be wed.
I, Elizabeth.
Give you, Grigor.
This ring, as a symbol
of my love and commitment.
With this ring, I be wed.
With this ring, I be wed.
At this point, the couple has chosen to do a wine ceremony. Elizabeth and Grigor, you have just committed yourselves by the pledge of your vows and the exchange of rings. Your life is now one. To celebrate your new union, we pour the wine on the table before us. As you pour the two different wines, we are reminded of your individuality, your many gifts and strengths, and your weaknesses, all that you individually bring to your marriage. This represents the two individual lives that are now blended like the two wines into one single life. Drinking of the combined wine signifies the commitment you may now make to live your lives as one family. Just as these wines can never be separated and poured again into individual containers, so will your marriage be. May you share this glass and join your lives as one. Before God, and in the presence of this congregation, Grigor and Elizabeth have made their solemn vows to each other. They have confirmed their promises by joining of hands and by giving and receiving of rings. Therefore, I proclaim that they are now husband and wife. Let us pray together in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. You may now kiss the bride. It is my pleasure to present to you, for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Grigor and Elizabeth Lynch.
Thank you. could please take their seat. Looks like everyone's seated. I'm going to introduce the bridal party. This time we're going to have a couple people propose some toasts.
Talk great.
Into it?
If you put it down here, no, it's right.
Okay. Hello, everyone. First off, I want to say how beautiful you look today, Elizabeth, and how snazzy you look today, Grigor. I want to thank everyone for coming tonight and for Elizabeth's parents and Grigor's parents for everything you've helped out throughout this whole process, so let's give a round of applause to them. So I was gonna start off my speech by reciting the marriage monologue from Princess Bride, but I've decided to save myself from embarrassment because if you guys wanna know, Elizabeth does it the best. So if you ever wanna hear it, you just need to ask her. I'm not gonna do it. I have known Elizabeth since about freshman year of high school, and I am so glad we became friends. We have so many memories from hanging out at the library during study hall, going to Dollywood, Washington, D.C. in the gummy worm situation and the giggle boxes, Wildwood, sleepovers at various friends' houses, and the summers during college. I am so thankful to have you in my life. Thank you for always being there for me, and thank you for always being you. I am so happy that you were able to find your forever friend in Grigor. Now, if everyone can raise your glasses for a toast.
I'm gonna raise my glass too.
Elizabeth and Grigor. Once in a while, right in the middle of an ordinary life, love gives us a fairy tale. Congratulations.
Hi everyone, I'm Kristen, and as Sarah said, thank you for being here. Elizabeth, you look beautiful. Grigor, you look great, and we'll carry on. 22 years ago, I was sitting next to Elizabeth at our preschool graduation from Candy Apple. Me in my frilly blue dress, and Elizabeth in her bowl cut hairdo. Little did we know that this was just the beginning of our friendship. We spent the next 9 years at St. Michael's making memories in our plaid jumpers. Then 4 years of high school together, where I could always count on her to have a box of tissues in her hand and a backpack so full it looked like she was living out of it. We spent 4 years at different colleges, keeping in touch the best we could and catching up each time life brought us back to Newark. That is until 9 o'clock when she had to be home. Another 4 years came and went. this time separated by 700 miles, sparking our 4 o'clock Thursday conversations. My phone rings at 4 o'clock, or her phone rings at 4 o'clock every Thursday. Friday, if we don't get each other on Thursday. Which brings us full circle to today, a new mark on the timeline of our friendship. This time, Elizabeth is in the frilly dress, and I could not do the bowl cut hairdo, sorry. When you've known someone for this long, their happiness becomes your own. I looked forward to the day that Elizabeth would find the person who would embrace every quality that I so admire in her. Her infectious laugh, her drive for success, her ability to be the most responsible friend in our group, but still not lose her playful spirit. Elizabeth, I am so glad that you have found someone in Grigor, someone who accepts you, balances you, and completes you exactly as you are. Grigor, thank you for accepting my best friend, for encouraging her in all her endeavors, for loving her each and every day, and tolerating her obsession for all things corgi. The two of you have not let distance, time, or Elizabeth's crazy friends break you apart. And for that, I know your love will last a lifetime. Elizabeth, in 22 years, I've called you many things. Elizabeth, Liz, Lizzie, even Galactic Giggle Girl. Anyone who knows her should figure out that's a good nickname. But today, I am honored and excited to call you by a new name, Mrs. Elizabeth Lynch. Here's to you and the man who has given you both his name and his love, and to the beginning of your forever. Cheers.
Hi, for those of you that don't know me, I'm Digo, Grigor's younger brother. I've known Grigor pretty much all my life, and obviously, and I've always looked up to him, and he has not let me down one bit. I'm so glad that he met his beautiful wife and now my sister-in-law, Elizabeth. Now, even though he's beaten me up a couple of times, I'm still glad that he found his perfect soulmate. I wish you guys the most happy, loving marriage possible. I love you.
Barely even friends, then somebody met.
Okay, I'd like to ask Elizabeth's father to join us on the dance floor for the father-daughter dance.
You got to get up every morning with a smile on your face and show the world all the love in your heart. Then people gonna treat you better. You're gonna find, yes you will, that you're beautiful as you feel. Waiting at the station with a workday window blowing, I've got nothing to do but watch the passers-by. Mirrored in their faces I see frustration growing, and they don't see it showing. Why do I? You got to get up every morning with a smile on your face and show the world all the love in your heart. Then people gonna treat you better. You're gonna find, yes you will, that you're beautiful.
Let's have a big round of applause for them. Okay, at this time, Grigor and his mother are gonna have a special dance.
Sweet dog.
the best, but you can make the times to come better than the rest. I know you will be honest if you can't always be kind. Oh, sweet darling, so glad you are a child of mine. Darling, so glad you are a child of mine. Child of mine, child of mine. Oh, yes, sweet darling, so glad you are a child of mine.
You're a falling star, you're the getaway car, you're the line in the sand when I go too far. You're the swimming pool on an August day, and you're the perfect thing to say. And you play it coy, but it's kinda cute. Oh, when you're smiling at me, you know exactly what you do. Baby, don't pretend that you don't know it's true, 'cause you can see it when I look at you. And in this crazy life, and through these crazy times, it's you, it's you. You make me sing your every line, your every word, your everything. You're a carousel, you're a wishing well, and you light me up when you ring my bell. You're a mystery, you're from outer space, you're every minute of my everyday. And I can't believe that I'm your man, and I get to kiss you, baby, just because I can. Whatever comes our way, I will see it through. me sing. You're every line, you're every word, you're everything. Everything, you're every song, and I sing along, 'cause you're my everything. La 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 la.